My name is Katarina Albuquerque, and I go by Katia because I like that name. And I'm 14 years old, and I've been dancing for 11 years. I love ballet because it's just so fun. It's kind of addicting. It's for people who say ballet is easy, it's not. It's definitely not. It's extremely hard, like, very hard. I don't have any words right now. You're working your body in a way that's not natural. Like, it's, you know, you have to work to get it. It's not something you already have, definitely. And your body's not used to it. It may feel weird, and it still does, but, you know, you just kind of get used to it.
The Allen Conservatory of Dance was founded in 1995, and in 1999 I had enough very talented students to lead me to want to start a nonprofit student pre-professional company so that dancers with ability would have a training ground if they wanted to become professionals.
So I'm Dewdrop Fairy, and it's basically, you know, the main role in like Waltz of the Flowers. So basically, how we made my Dewdrop costume was we had a leotard, like the right color, and we cut it up to make it like a bodice, and we just added a skirt with some material. My dance teacher, she went to a thrift store and got a prom dress, and she just basically detached the sparkly sequins off, and we used it for my Dewdrop costume. We were thinking of putting wings because I'm a Dewdrop Fairy, but we couldn't find any good ones, so that didn't work.
If they were not shaped like a giant bow. No.
You're a tiny little lettuce like this.
I love lettuce. You're
like, tiny little lettuce.
I love lettuce.
I did it the first time. Like, she's just lettuce. This is the tomato for the salad.
Tomato for the dressing.
I'm Leo, short for Leonardo. I'm 17 years old. I have been dancing for 1 year and almost a month now. I started in 2016. I always liked to dance, but I never considered doing it because, you know, the whole, oh, don't do this because you're a guy, or, you know, that kind of stuff. So, but one of my friends, Anya, that is recording right now, she said, you should come to the studio so you can dance, you know, practice or whatever. I was like, sure. And that's how it all started. I didn't think it was going to be easy, but I didn't think it was going to be that hard either. So I was like, okay, fine, let's do it, right? But whenever I got there and I took that first class, so it was, oh my god, that's so hard. And I was like, okay, I want to get better because I look ridiculous right now because I cannot even do the more basic stuff because I thought it was going to be so easy, as I said. But yeah, I think that was like just the fact that it was hard and I wanted to improve, and that made me stay there, dancing at the studio. Nutcracker was the prince. It was so scary. I wasn't really expecting it, but it was really cool to do it, just in general.
Paul. And he comes in a week before the show because he can't be here. He lives in Arkansas. And basically he comes a week before the show just to rehearse with Emma and Nora.
The Alice Cohn turns, you're...
Right.
So slow. So just speed that up a little bit. Just stop. To get it right. That's better. And then...
I decided to teach ballet because I have a real passion for the art form and I want to be able to pass it on to the next generation because this is really a performing art of tradition and history that really needs to be learned by successive generations. The thing that people typically get wrong about ballet is that they think that it's boring and that they won't enjoy it. I think if they went to a ballet performance, I think they would be pleasantly surprised.
My name is Paul Tillman. I'm a professional dancer, and I've been dancing professionally for 8 years now. I started dancing when I was 7 years old. My parents put me in a dance class because I was dancing around at home all the time and just thought I needed to get the energy. People are usually really surprised to hear that I'm a professional ballet dancer as a male. A lot of times will ask you, like, oh, when are you going to get a real job or something like that, not realizing that it is a career and a full-time job that I do 9 to 5 every single day.
You, in the other room, I need to see, we're going to go with snow scene. If you're a party child, get out of here and go into the snow scene room until I call you for co-op.
Last week before Nutcracker, there is usually a lot to prepare for. So for the whole week, we were at the studio till late at night rehearsing. Normally, before a performance, we warm ourselves up, but none of us actually wanted to warm up, so we just ended up sitting around.
Ooh, we got it!
Then we go to the pack, which is where we're performing, and we just make sure we have all our makeup on and our leotards and costumes ready, and then we run everything from the start.
Here, right? Remember I told you that you try to end up in the same place? Are you in the same place that you were a minute ago? Well then, can you get into the same place where you were a minute ago? All right, got it. Thank you.
Because they need to know the tempo of the dance that we are doing. If the orchestra plays too fast, we tell them to slow down because it'll change the dance. Like, some of it may be like chaotic if it's too fast. And you know, if it's too slow, you know, like you can't hold a balance for about an hour or so.
But this, if you want to take a 15-minute break, this is great because we need to change. I need land this week.
Is something that really got to change my life in general, because I never saw myself as a stage person, because I am so introvert, you know, like I don't like talking in front of the whole class. I'm a very introvert person, so being on a stage for me is something that I would never imagine. Being here at the PAC and seeing all those people, like more than, I didn't even know, the PAC was full. And me just standing there in full costume, it was just something that I would never imagine at all, ever. Because I think that I was just gonna drop that right there. Because I thought that I wouldn't be able to take the pressure. It was a new kind of feeling for me, like this adrenaline that I never felt before in my life. And even though I don't dance much as the prince on the Nutcracker, it gave me experience, you know, in a way that I don't feel as nervous as I used to be when I am on stage.
I was kind of nervous because no one was there to tell me what to do. Like, I had to figure it out, make sure I was in the right places, and like, the timing is different when you're on a bigger stage, and that's another thing, so you have to like, enter earlier a little bit, you know, to come on to your entrance and stuff like that. The feeling of being on stage is really great and exciting, but you just, you know, you want to make sure you stay calm, because it's very like, weird being on stage. Hundreds of people or thousands are watching you, and you just want to make sure you're not nervous, because that can really affect the way you dance. But it's really fun once you get used to it, and once you've already experienced it, it's different the second time, the third time.
styles of ballet. There's the Italian or Cicchetti method, there's Royal Academy of Dancing, there's Vaganova. I teach what is mostly taught in the United States, which is sort of a little bit of everything, with a distinct Russian influence, since my teacher was Russian.
Every single one of us is going to do exactly the same thing, right? And it's going to be a diagonal to the corner, but you got to be on your own path. It's going to be down, up, up, down, up, up.
So we're basically doing this piece. It's called Hush by Mountain. I'm playing this girl who's thinking of committing suicide, but it's kind of up to her because there are three poison fairies. So they have a cup. They're trying to get me to drink it. And it's, like I said, it's up to me. Leo's role is just trying to get me not to drink it. He's not really a person in the storyline. He's just basically, he's like a spirit trying not to get me to drink it. He's not a person, but the only person in the whole dance is me, and it's like my choice whether I want to die or live.
What happens at the end?
In the end, I die. First dances that I'm actually doing many lifts in it. I'm really excited. It's kind of fun, but it's also very challenging. We're doing a lot of new lifts, and we just kind of have to work together.
Isn't far to hush up my mountain, and your boat waits down by the key. The winds of night so soft.
So the music will start, then she'll run out, she'll dance, she'll be, and then she'll finish on stage, she'll come back to the center, she'll go back, and she will go, who's the next person? Okay, so when she sees the paint, she's going to walk out, she's going to go to her place, she's going to take her place, she's going to pose, right? And then Reza's gonna start and she's gonna dance and she's gonna go away. Wait, she bows. And then she goes away.
Yeah, so can you do it from the top? Thank you.
Thank you.
competition, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so how do we feel about that? Can we live with that? Is it good? Is there any place that feels like it needs anything?
How was the ending? Was it?
Ending was good, except her flower didn't come out, but yes. Yeah. We're okay?
I'm not going to lie. I used to think that ballet was easy, and that's what I was expecting on my first class. And it was such a shock for me. Once a person told me, like, ballet is so easy, you know, like, why so easy? And I said, okay, do a tendu, which is like one of the most basic steps. And the person was like, sure. And the person did it like totally wrong, as I was expecting, and I corrected, and after, he was like, oh, my leg hurts. I was like, yep, that's how it goes.
Yeah, if someone were to tell me that ballet were easy, I would tell them that they should come and take a ballet class and see how they feel afterwards. It's a little bit harder than yoga, I'll put it that way. A lot of football players, in fact, will come to ballet to train to get extra strength and flexibility for games and stuff like that. So it's a good cross-training method for professional athletes.
So cool. Come on, Julie, let's go.
yes, I will be doing ballet for the rest of my life. Well, no, until like my body can take it. You can't really stop the urge once you start dancing. Like, you can't just stop unless you injure yourself. You know, it's really sad to stop. And if you can keep going, why not?
Honestly, I can't picture living my life another way than pursuing this career that I have. It's something that I can't breathe without thinking about ballet. It's just a part of who I am so much that I honestly can't think of another way that I would have chosen my life to go.
I look at how I was like exactly 1 year ago to how I am now, and the improvement is just crazy. I can do things that I honestly would never imagine that I could do at all. Just being in a stage was, it's just like being able to lift, and it's just something that I never thought of before. I want to do it for a very long time still, and I still have a long way to go. Pain and suffering. I'm kidding, guys. The ballet is great. It's so easy. Go do it. Yeah, I still have a long way to go, and there's a lot of room for improvement. So that's what I am aiming for. So, yeah.